So this is a vintage 1950s something Airguide Marine Speedometer out of a little 16-foot mahogany runabout I have that I've been restoring the boat. Took this off to clean it up and wanted to clean up all this, so I decided I would unscrew that nut. And as I was unscrewing it, I didn't realize that this was also turning and snapped off of something. I didn't know what had happened because I didn't know at the time what was inside one of these. So this video is going to be about rebuilding and restoring one of these speedometers. It's pretty interesting, actually. This is what's inside of that, and this copper tubing is what I broke off. So I basically had to buy copper tubing and solder it onto the back, solder it onto this, reroute it, and adjust it so that it ends up a functioning speedometer. So the first thing I did was I sprayed WD-40, stuff that loosens tight bolts. I forget the name of that stuff, but anyway, I squirted some of that in there, put it in a plastic bag, stuck it in the freezer, took it out, and that's where the video basically begins. So, hope you enjoy it. It's pretty interesting. I just think the inner workings of this thing is just so interesting. You've got like a, almost like a mainspring and a clock down there. You've got this thing that's on this fulcrum. I attached this air thing to it, but to show you. So as air gets pushed into the, as water gets pushed into the tube in the back of the boat, it pressurizes the tubing and then makes the speedometer move up. But how that does it is, I just think it's just so interesting. It's just so analog. Air gets pushed into this copper tubing and then fills up the diaphragm here, which then puts pressure. That's hard to see because it's inside here, but it basically puts pressure on something that then moves this lever, which is wrapped around the shaft in there. So that's wrapped around the shaft, so as the lever moves, but then it's all spring-loaded by that main spring in there. I just think it's so cool. Going 15 miles an hour. Anyway. So this video is about restoring this, putting in a new tube, and getting it back into this condition, which is the end result. But, so anyway. So let me be clear that I broke the one off my boat, and not knowing if I'd be able to fix it or what I had done to it, I got on eBay and I bought a backup speedometer. I was able to find one. And I wanted to see if it wasn't possible to take it apart correctly, because the first time I used a razor blade and cut through the rubber gasket and I marked up the face and everything. And so I was kind of determined to figure out a way to disassemble it correctly. So I have had this in the fridge for a day. The freezer, not the fridge. Had this in the freezer. And hopefully it will allow me to get this cover off. I'm gonna have to tap it, I can tell. I just can't free tap it or pry it. I see it moving. Oh yeah. So putting that, there we go. Perfect. Perfectamundo. Dang. Awesome. I have not quite figured out how I'm going to get this glass out. I don't want to chip it. But, and I think it is literally just in there with a, I think it's pressed in there. I think they just put a little bit of rubberized cut this at that angle with a razor blade because I had no idea how to get in there and I didn't want to reach in there and chip it, trying to pull it out. So worst case scenario, I'll use an X-Acto knife, but I am going to try and shimmy something in there, maybe a razor blade, and just try and pull this glass out. You know, maybe also just, yeah, that's not gonna do it. Hitting that out. There is a little bit of a gap on this side, so I think I will trying to pry it out. This pin is not a good idea because it's too thick. Yeah, I can always. So I need to get something down in between the rubber and this glass, something not pressing on the glass. So I'll figure that out and be back. So I can get the razor blade down here and I don't want to chip the glass, but oh my gosh, look at that. Awesome. Wow, that was easy. Huh, glass just popped off. There is a, what looks like a rubber, I don't know if that's a washer. Oh, it is, look at this. Oh, wow. Interesting. A little rubber seal. Huh. Very cool. Wow. Dang. All right, so I know that this thing should just pull off. The top of this little, there's a little nub. And I don't know if it's been flattened down or made to be a little wider, so I'm gonna try and make sure. Should pull off, but as with everything, you never want to force it. So I may put a little bit of that same stuff I put on the rim here. I don't know why I can never remember that. It's a thing to loosen up bolts. So you can, in this, there's a little notch there, a little notch there, and a little notch down here, indicating that's in there very, very snugly. So getting this face off is going to be a little interesting, but first I want to get this off. There we go. It's coming. Just gently. There we go. Sweet. Now this face is on here pretty darn tight, I have to say. It's definitely not loose, so that's going to be a tough one. There's no way to go from the backside. Hi-yi-yi. So the outside of the ring comes to the top of these letters here. So this nub is hidden. In fact, from here, it's like 16th of an inch, 8th of an inch, from here to here is hidden. So I'm going to try and get this pick down in here without bending the face, using my thumb as a fulcrum. I'm going to try and get this thing up. There we go. Like, this is all hidden, so it doesn't matter, in a way, how much I... muck up this outer edge. Maybe I'll help it along on this side. I'm sure they never meant these things to be taken apart. Here again, I've got some, like, this will never be seen. This whole thing will never be seen. So I can. Use it to lift it up. Let's see here. Voila. Sweet. Okay, now we can see how this thing was meant to be. Dang, that's awesome. Okay, so this thing winds away around there. Look at that. There's a freaking spider web in here. Wow. Okay, so we can see how this works. You've got to secure this nut in there while undoing this one. Because that is how I broke the first one. And with that done, secure that, come on the backside, unscrew these two screws. And with this, you'll be able to pull this out. As you can see, I haven't had this one actually apart. I kind of wanted the original speedometer to be in my boat. I didn't really want to get a replacement, so. But like I said, not knowing if I'd be able to fix it or not, I bought this one. So then what I did, first thing I did was I straightened this tubing out. And in doing that, I weakened this fairly sharp corner here. And through, you know, manipulating it, I weakened it to a point where it actually cracked. So I ended it up with a soldering iron, taking that solder out and removing this whole tube, buying some tubing on Amazon, and reattaching the tubing. And that's where the next part of the video will pick up. The back will be open. I'm working on the original speedometer. So I bought about 16 feet for $9 of this same tubing off Amazon. Should be smooth. Should just blend right into both pieces, but it's pretty, seems pretty firm. So then I just have to bend this up and around here and then out this way. So when I blow into this side, you can see it move here. See how this one goes. Around, back in, and then out. It's gonna get me close. Not too tough to bend. Just gotta make sure you don't press too far on one section and bend it 90 degrees.